In the NHL, we usually associate different players with different types of skills. For example, Connor McDavid, we usually associate him with his blazing speed. I mean, seriously, the guy can't even skate in school zones. It's so ridiculous. Another example is Alexander Ovechkin for his rocket shot, especially on the power play. I guess you don't have half your career goals on the power play for no reason. And another example would be Tom Wilson's ability to not get kicked out of the league despite being the dirtiest player year in and year out. I mean, seriously, this guy's a fucking greaseball. And it's not always the star guys who have these sort of abilities. The first guy who kind of comes to mind is a guy like Kasperi Kapanen, who meanwhile he's a great top six player. He isn't a star, but he exhibits the same kind of category of speed that you'd see on these top tier kind of players. And obviously, to win a Stanley Cup and to succeed in the league, you have to have players of all different types of skill types. But then I got to thinking myself, what would it be like if we put every single player of the same talent on the same team? So what I mean by that is, what if I put all the snipers, like David Pastrnak, Alexander Ovechkin, all those guys on the same team? What if I put all the speedsters, like Kasperi Kapanen, Nathan MacKinnon, and Connor McDavid on the same team? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create 6 different teams devised of different skills, create a mini regular season, and then a tournament at the end of the year, and see who can come out as the winner, and will determine which skill is the most important. So now what I will be doing is showing you guys the 6 teams that I have created. I'll show you guys their arenas, their mascots, their rosters, everything. I'll let you guys pick a favorite, and I'll let you guys decide who you want to win and hopefully root for a team, and hopefully that they win it. And our first team is the Detroit Defenders. The Defenders are led by Captain Patrice Bergeron, with Kyle Connor, Ryan O'Reilly on his wing. Second line is Sean Couturier, Anze Kopitar, Jonathan Toews. The third line is Sean Monahan, Bo Horvat, Zach Hyman. The fourth line is Brock Nelson, Kevin Hayes, and Vinny Trocheck. The defense was hard to find people for. We have Ryan McDonough, Ryan Ellis, Ryan Suter, Colton Pareko, Zdeno Chara, and Matt Dumba. So a lot of Ryans to start. And in the cage, we have Mackenzie Blackwood and Ilya Sorokin. And now we have the Boston Brainiacs, led by Captain Sidney Crosby, who'll have Sebastian Aho and Mark Stone playing on his wing in the first line. Second line is Gabriel Landeskog, Mark Scheifele, and Travis Konecny. The third line is Nico Hischier, Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, and Nick Suzuki. The fourth line is Philippe Deneau, Jordan Staal, and Connor Brown. And their defense is probably the best part of their team, with Victor Hedman, Rasmus Ristolainen, Darnell Nurse, Morgan Riley, Nick Leddy, and Esa Lindell. In the cage, they get some solid goaltending from Sergei Bobrovsky and Braden Holtby to back them up. And next up are the Glendale Goons. And here are your Glendale Goons, led by Captain Tom Wilson, playing with Evgeny Malkin and Brad Marchand on the first line. The second line is the Tkachuk line, with Matthew Tkachuk, Brady Tkachuk, and Claude Giroux down the middle. The third line is Evander Kane, Nazem Kadri, and Tyler Bertuzzi. Fourth line is Jamie Benn, Ryan Getzlaff, and of course, Ryan Reeves. On defense, we have Dustin Byfuglien, Drew Doughty, Charlie McAvoy, Shea Weber, Nikita Zadorov, and Rasmus Ristolainen. I really don't know why Charlie McAvoy is on here. I just needed to boost their overall, and Charlie McAvoy was the only one I could do that with. And for goalies, we have Jacob Markstrom and Jordan Binnington. I needed to boost their overall again, so Jacob Markstrom was the only guy I could find. Obviously, Bennington's a little bitch and tries to fight everybody, so he's on here. And next up are the Pittsburgh Playmakers, led by Captain Patrick Kane, who will have Jack Eichel and Nikita Kucherov on the first line with him, Jonathan Huberdeau, Elias Pettersson, and Mitchell Marner on the second line, with Clayton Keller, Nick Backstrom, and Blake Wheeler taking up the third line. The fourth line has young stars like Jack Hughes, young stars like Joe Thornton, and Sam Reinhart. Their defense isn't as good, but it's still very good, with Thomas Chabot, Adam Fox, Oliver Ekman-Larsson, Miro Heiskanen, Rasmus Dahlin, and Duncan Keith. Their goalies are Igor Shesterkin and Semyon Vermolov. And next up, we have the Sacramento Snipers. And here goes the star-studded offense of the Snipers, led by Captain Alexander Ovechkin, alongside with Leon Draisaitl and David Pastrnak on the first line. Second line is Artemi Panarin, Austin Matthews, and Mikko Rantanen. Third line is Victor Olofsson, Alex DeBrincat, and Brock Besser. Fourth line is GOAT Glizzy Gladiator Phil Kessel, along with Patrick Laine at center for some odd reason, and Tyler Toffoli on the other side. Their defense even has snipers like Shea Theodore, Jeff Petrie, Jacob Chikrin, Tyson Barrie, Shane Gostisbehere, and Ryan Pulock. Their goaltending is capped off with a great goaltender in Marc-Andre Fleury, and somebody who doesn't have a glove hand in Tristan Jarry. And now for our last team, the Seattle Speedsters. And here go their lines, led by Captain Connor McDavid. On his wings are Nathan MacKinnon, Johnny Gaudreau on the first line. The second line is Taylor Hall, Steven Stamkos, and Braden Point. Third line is Dylan Larkin, Matt Barzal, and William Nylander. The fourth line is Kirill Kaprizov, Matt Duchene, and Nikolai Ehlers. Their defense is Quinn Hughes, Kale McCarr, Torrey Krug, John Klingberg, Morgan Riley, and Erik Karlsson. And this is where they lack. They have Vitek Vanacek and Jonathan Quick in the net. As you guys can see, every single team is a 94 overall, all six of them. So I've simulated the 10-game regular season, and the results should be popping up right now. First place team is the Playmakers. They went 7-3. Second place team are the Goons with a 6-2-2 record. Third place is the Snipers with a 6-4 record. Fourth is the Brainiacs with a 5-5 record. And fifth is the Defenders with a 4-6 record. And then in sixth and last place are the Speedsters with a 2-8 record. So what we're going to do is have the Defenders and the Speedsters play each other in a best of three series and see who wins that. And then after that, they'll have to play the Brainiacs. And out of those three teams, whoever gets in will have the fourth spot and will have to play the Playmakers in the first round. We are ready to go. We got our first play-in round matchup to determine who gets in the playoffs. We got the Speedsters against the Defenders. So we're going to start the game here. We're in the first period. Let's see what happens. We got a and a goal from Matt Barzal on Mackenzie Blackwood. Kirill Kaprizov, so the fourth and third line, and there goes the first line for the Speedsters. And there goes Jonathan Toews. So they're right back into it. They get a greasy goal in front of the net. It's a 3-1 game now. And another one, Bo Horvat, and then Quinn Hughes back. Bo Horvat gets another one, his second of the game. Kirill Kaprizov, he gets his second of the game on the power play again, and Quinn Hughes gets his second of the game, a 6-3 game. Patrice Bergeron scores, 7 minutes left. They put him on the power play again. The Defenders just can't stay out the box. A high scoring game, Mackenzie Blackwood. So now for the second game, let's see what can happen. Kyle Connor scores. Gonna have to come out. They came out hot. Bo Horvat again, his third goal of the series. Bo Horvat is a big time performer. And there goes Ryan McDonagh. Nathan MacKinnon scores his second goal of the series. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then that's it. It's now a 1-1 series. This game will determine who gets to move on and play another series against the Brainiacs. And we're starting game three right into it. And scores Ryan O'Reilly, the Selke Trophy winner. And Steven Stamkos gets one right back for the Speedsters. Braden Point, 2 Tampa Bay Lightning score. And now it's a 2-1 game for the Speedsters. And Kyle Connor gets his third goal. Matt Barzal scores. It's 3-2. And Steven Stamkos gets his second of the game. But Patrice Bergeron answers before the period. 10 minutes left. Steven Stamkos with the hat trick. Oh, Mackenzie Blackwood. And there goes Connor McDavid. A meaningless goal. McSecondary assist finds the score sheet. 3-2-1. And 0. The Speedsters are moving on. They will play the Brainiacs to determine who gets the fourth seed. The Brainiacs against the Speedsters. Let's see who takes this series. And the Speedsters open up hot. Johnny Gaudreau, Vitek Vanacek was the Speedster. Kryptonite, Rasmus Ristolainen gets on the board. A point shot. And Sidney Crosby, the captain for the Brainiacs. But Nikolai Ehlers gets one right back with 11 minutes left. And they couldn't do anything with it. And Connor Brown scores. Let's hop into this game. Connor Brown had scored just before I went into the simulation. It's a 3-2 game for the Brainiacs. McDavid has one shot. He has a zero in the plus minus. Eric Carlson to Matt Barzal skating in. What a save by Bobrovsky. Sidney Crosby taking the dot against Connor McDavid. Past versus present. Ristolainen takes it, carries it up to Sidney Crosby, the captain. He gave them the tie. And what the fuck was Sebastian Aho doing, buddy? You gotta stay on sides there, you Bigfoot fucker. Still taking the face-off against each other's past and present. Crosby ends up, okay, Sebastian Aho, what are you doing, bro? What are you doing? Come on, seriously. Third draw in a row. Crosby, McDavid, part three. Crosby won the first two. McDavid will take number three. Crosby's going to forecheck in on Hughes. Hughes to Makar. Gaudreau takes it. Gets hit. Here comes McDavid. McDavid on a 3-on-2. McDavid has a shot. Saved by Bobrovsky, and he'll cover up. All right. Crosby against McDavid, part four. Let's see what happens. Bobrovsky has 23 saves, and Crosby will take his third draw against McDavid there. Victor Hedman a shot, won't go. Here comes Hughes. Hughes circles back, looking, finds Makar. Makar will take it. He'll skate it out to McDavid. McDavid coming down. Sid hits him from behind. What a hit. Here comes Rasmus Ristolainen. Shot. Oh, just over the neck. Vitek Vanacek had no idea where it went. Gaudreau gets pinned by Sid. Here goes Hughes. Hughes up to McDavid. They are pulling the goalie now. Braden Point circling around. They'll get McKinnon on the ice. McDavid cycles the puck up to McKinnon. Blocked by Darnell Nurse. The Norris winner. Here comes Travis Konechny. Shot and it's over. The Brainiacs will take game one. They get an empty net to seal the deal. It's a 1-0 series lead for the Brainiacs, but the Speedsters look to answer. They want to make it to the last place in the regular season, and they're trying. McDavid, McSecondary assist, picks up his second goal. Vitek Vanacek shutting the door. 5 minutes left, 4 minutes left, 3 minutes left, 2 minutes. Let's head into the game. We're in IQ Island for this game in Boston. The Boston Brainiacs looking to come back here with a minute left. The Speedsters, Nylander to Barzal. A shot. Nylander has it. Why didn't he shoot it? I have no idea. He must be retarded. All right, here comes Mark Scheifele. Darnell Nurse. Landeskog skating past him. This is supposed to be a Speedsters team. Shot. What a save by Vitek Vanacek again. Oh, Vitek Vanacek's on his head right now for the Speedsters. They're going to have to buy him lunch after this one. William Nylander cycling out. Dylan Larkin. Nothing there. Morgan Rielly takes it right off his stick. Morgan Rielly circles back around to Gabe Landeskog. Gabe Landeskog up to Mark Scheifele. Killed Jake Evans. I thought about putting him on the Goons team, and he's dead too. That was for Jake Evans, you cocksucker. Here comes Nylander up. An empty net for the Brainiacs. Barzal ends it. Nylander to Barzal. This game's over, and we're heading to a game three. 82 overall. Vitek Vanacek has shut the door on the Brainiacs. Game and Cale Makar gets the first goal, and it's not looking good for the Brainiacs. They can't find a way to beat Vitek Vanacek. 6 minutes left. 5 minutes left. And another goal, Nate McKinnon. Here come the Speedsters. We're going to go in. They have a power play for pretty much the rest of the game. Now let's see what happens. Philippe Deneau, and I don't know who else is out there. Darnell Nurse, the Norris Trophy winner, and they're within one. They finally find a way to beat Vitek Vanacek, and they are within one goal now. Can the Norris Trophy winner lead them to success? Let's see. Picked off by Nate McKinnon. Here he is on goal. What a save by Sergei Bobrovsky. Nate McKinnon back to Makar. Poked away. Can he get it? Oh, no. They're too fast. They're a speedster team. It's what they do. They're quick. Braden Point. Oh, absolutely rocked. Victor Hedman picks up the puck. They need to go. Ristolainen. Here comes Landeskog. A minute left in the game. Can't get it. Oh, what is he doing? He's shimmy shaking. Oh, Jordan Staal dead too. Oh, there's bodies flying all over the ice. Steven Stamkos can't pick up his head. He's Sebastian Aho. He's an idiot. He takes it back. Finds Ristis. Rasmus Ristolainen. What is that dude doing in the left corner? He was just going outside. Mark Stone. Here he comes. Down the boards. Oh, curls in! Oh, it couldn't be Vitek Vanacek. There is an empty net down there. And he's absolutely rocked by Mark Stone, but he gets rocked. Aho picks it up. Stalls out there. Where is Sidney Crosby? What are the Brainiacs doing? Mark Scheifele, a save by Vitek Vanacek. Steven Stamkos up to Makar. This could seal it. He's looking for the empty net. Blocked by Victor Hedman. 19 seconds left. Here comes Scheifele. Scheifele to Riley. Riley finds Mark Stone. Picked off by Nylander. Here comes Brayden Point. Intercepted in off of Larkin, and this goes into the crowd. Darnell Nurse has 6 block shots in this game. Nylander takes it. They put their goalie back. What are they doing? Why would they do that? It's an all or nothing game. Travis Konechny grabs the puck. Shot. Vitek Vanacek the save, and it's over. They're moving on. The Speedsters will be the 4th seed and play the 1st seed Playmakers in round number 1. And so now we have our bracket set. We have our 4 teams, and they are going to play in best of 3 series to determine who will move on and play each other to decide what skill is most important in the NHL. We have the Speedsters against the Playmakers, and they score McSecondary assist. Matt Barzal with a shorthanded goal. Patrick Kane gets one back on Vitek Vanacek. 2-2! Young man Joe Thornton. Matt Duchene scores a goal, and Nathan MacKinnon right back. So they take a 4-2 lead here. And there it goes. The Hart Trophy winner, Mitch Marner, gets one. And we're in past first park for this one. It is a loud stadium, and this is going to be a good game. Makar almost turns the puck over, and Brayden Point is already offsides and doing a toe drag. Sick. McDavid wins the faceoff to Goudreau. Goudreau gets poke checked back to Makar. Makar circles around, poke checked off his stick. He finds McDavid. McDavid finds MacKinnon. Zooming up the wing. Tries to dangle. Just speeding past everybody. And Shesterkin covers up to Goudreau. Goudreau tied up along the boards. Here comes Adam Fox to Kucherov. He dangles. Kucherov looking. Knocked off the puck. Goudreau has it. He can't go anywhere with it. The Playmakers haven't even been able to enter the zone yet. And Makar skates it out of trouble. Here comes Makar. Someone off the bench, and it's a turnover. Here comes Jack Eichel. Jack Eichel turns around. Can't find nothing. Played off the wall. Makar takes it. He's been out there for forever. Taylor Hall looking around for the Speedsters. Walks in to Brayden Point to McDavid. McSecondary assist almost puts it home. Mitch Marner to Chabot. Here they come. They're going to need to get down the ice. They're pulling the goalie. Huberto finds Eichel. What a save by Vitek Vanacek. Point hands up to Makar. Makar with an empty net. Can he score? No, he misses it. 9 seconds. They got to get down the ice quick. Miro Heiskanen to Jack Eichel. 6 seconds. Everybody's back. Here he comes. Whoa, what a save by Vitek Vanacek. Another. Oh, it was in. What happened? It was in. What just happened? One of the craziest endings I have ever seen. Jack Eichel comes along the side. A sauce pass. Huberto is stoned by Vitek Vanacek. Mitch Marner somehow finds this puck between 2 guys and finds Patty Kane. Oh, man, I don't know. I cannot believe that that's a no goal. And so now in the other series, the Speedsters hold on to take a 1-0 lead. But now we have the Sacramento Snipers against the Glendale Goons. And Evgeny Malkin beats the Vezina Trophy winner, Marc-Andre Fleury, and Patrick Laine, as soon as the power play expires, Brock Besser, another goal. And they score, Brad Marchand, before the period ends. Jeff Petrie, a rocket on the power play. They're in Goon Square Garden for this game. Can the Snipers hold on to beat the Glendale Goons? Tyler Bertuzzi picks it up, finds Kane, Evander Kane to Shea Weber. Shea Weber looking. A couple dangles, couldn't find nothing. Is that Patrick Laine? He's just going to get it deep. A smart play by Patrick Laine. Here comes Evander Kane. The Snipers with Phil Kessel. They're just looking to hang on here. Kadri with a toe drag. Cycles up the boards. Nothing there. Tyler Bertuzzi comes over. Couldn't find it. Laine picks it up again. He's doing all the work, and they're pulling the goaltender now. Evander Kane. He finds Tyler Bertuzzi. Sneaks past just a bit. Oh, and Shea Theodore picks off the pass. Holy moly, Tyler Toffoli, can he end it? Phil Kessel knocked down, and they still have 33 seconds to get an opportunity. Here he comes. He tries to fight through everybody, and he gets rocked. Patrick Laine just dumps it in. Another smart play. Patrick Laine playing great. down to Dustin Byfuglien. Dustin Byfuglien finds Evgeny Malkin to Evander Kane. Evander Kane dangles somebody through the middle. A 2-1. Evgeny Malkin with 14 seconds left. And it's a 3-3 game. The Goons have tied it. We are now going into the overtime. Line 1 versus line 1. Ovi Draisaitl in Pasternak. What a line that is. Dustin Byfuglien just walks around Draisaitl. Tom Wilson, here he comes. The GOAT. Brad Marchand ends it on Marc-Andre Fleury early. The Goons win it. Tom Wilson finds Brad Marchand, and they take a 1-0 lead in the series. And we're back to see the playmakers versus the speedsters. And Clayton Keller opens up the scoring for the playmakers. And Patrick Kane does help them convert on a power play. But John Klingberg gets one right back. And Mitch Marner a goal. And but Connor McSecondary assist gets another goal. We get to see the Jolly Rancher jerseys in full effect. They look great on the playmakers. Matt Barzal loses the faceoff. Let's see. The playmakers are up one. The speedsters need to come back offside. Last game was pretty unbelievable. A late goal. Here he comes. Here he comes. McDavid straight through the middle, and it's offsides again. What are you guys fucking doing? It's just a bunch of idiots. Thanks, Connor McSecondary assist. All right, taking the faceoff. McDavid against Jack Eichel. Let's see. Both the same draft class, that 2015 draft class. Unbelievable. Here comes Johnny Gaudreau. And he gets absolutely killed. Is that not a penalty? The dude loses his face on the board. Nathan MacKinnon. The game is tied. 51 seconds left from McSecondary assist to Nate MacKinnon. Superplex. And there goes Quinn Hughes. He skates it up. He finds Nate MacKinnon. He has the game tying goal already. Makar. And he gets tripped. The speedsters are going to go on a 43-second power play here. The playmakers might get knocked out despite being the best team in the regular season. McSecondary assist. Almost a rebound. Chabot clears it the whole length of the ice. 37 seconds left. Vitek Vanacek back in the net. Kale Makar skating it up for McDavid. McDavid's got speed. Blazing pass, but he turns it over to Blake Wheeler. And he gets it out the zone. Back to Kale Makar. Kale Makar finds Nate MacKinnon. Nate McKinnon's absolutely rocked on the boards. Ekman Larsson finds Chabot. Chabot just needs to get it out, and he throws it into the bench with 16 seconds left. Bo Thornton and Jack Eichel out here on the penalty kill for the playmakers. This would be a huge penalty kill. Heiskanen clears it the full length of the ice. 13 seconds left. Let's see if they can get one more shot. Kale Makar. Intercepted Joe Thornton! Joe Thornton back to Duncan Keith. Heiskanen, what a save by Vitek Vanacek. How many times have we said that? He has bailed the Speedsters team out time and time again. And it's going crazy in the Speed Superplex. They're looking to take home this series. They want to do it on home ice. They want to go to the next series. A win back to Ekman Larsson. They're still shorthanded for another minute. He's just going to skate back here. MacKinnon, who has the game-tying goal with 51 seconds left, finds McDavid. Back to MacKinnon. Oh, what a save from Igor Shesterkin. He gets lit up, but Chabot takes it and clears it out again, and he almost found Kaner on the breakaway. Skates it around. Here he comes. McDavid tries to dangle through. Can't find it. MacKinnon. Stamkos. What a save again by Igor Shesterkin. Backstrom skates it out of danger. Looking for some offense finally. Backstrom to Kane. A save by Vitek Vanacek. And he lets it out. He's a fucking savage. Here comes Nate MacKinnon. Nate MacKinnon skates it around. Gets poke checked off. Dahlin, what a great play. Adam Fox finds Jack Eichel. Jack Eichel back to Nikita Kucherov. Trying to skate it out against his Tampa Bay teammates. He finds Adam Fox! What a goal! Patrick Kane and the playmakers tie the series at one. And now we have the Glendale Goons against the Sacramento Snipers. A power play goal! Again, Evgeny Malkin. And Ryan Getzlaf, that ugly bastard, that bald-headed fuck. Alexander Ovechkin from that corner finds a way to bury it. Another power play goal. Jamie Benn. Here we go. Ryan Getzlaf taking the faceoff for the Goons, looking to keep them off the score sheet. The Snipers have some sick fucking jerseys, that's for sure. Here they come. Who's that, Jamie Benn? Somebody just took a backhand on net. What the hell was he doing? Austin Matthews skates it up to Mikko Rantanen. 3-on-2. Mikko Rantanen finds space. What a save by Jacob Markstrom. Panarin to Phil Kessel. Another save. Another save by Markstrom, and he's keeping them in there. Six skaters on the ice. Two top lines out against each other. A win by Draisaitl. Jeff Petrie, what a shot! Oh my goodness, what a save again! Jacob Markstrom standing on his head! And here they go, they're gonna take it down. They're looking for something. They're trying to skate it out of their zone. There's just too many guys. Tom Wilson up to Evgeny Malkin. He misses the net. What is that guy skating backwards for? What is he doing? Blew the game. Jeff Petrie. Evgeny Malkin scores again. Hats off to Jacob Markstrom, who just played a hell of a last minute there. And then Evgeny Malkin buries the empty netter. And the Snipers are going home. The Goons are moving on. And back to the Speedsters versus Playmakers series, a 1-1 series. Steven Stamkos opens up the scoring for the Speedsters, and Dylan Larkin with a power play goal. Patrick Kane on Vitek Vanacek, 4 minutes left in the first, but Johnny Gaudreau responds quickly. Nick Backstrom with a goal. Cal Makar gets one early to start the period. 4-2, a minute 37 left. Let's see if the Speedsters can pull off a crazy upset. Willie Nylander absolutely crushed by Chabot. Here comes Pettersson. Pettersson looking for the Hart Trophy winner. Mitch Marner finds him. What a save again. Vitek Vanacek. They need to get one. Back to Makar. A great face-off win by McSecondary assist. Hughes to McDavid. McDavid finds Makar. Makar skating it out of danger. The Playmakers need to get pressure. They need two goals. A save from Shesterkin, and he throws it out to Chabot. Chabot looking around. He has nowhere to go with the puck. Circles back and finds Kucherov. Kucherov gets hit. McDavid takes it around. McDavid looking for open space. Gets poke checked quickly. 30 seconds left and somebody's dead on the ice. McSecondary assist picks it up to McDavid. McKinnon back. Here he comes. He finds Nikita Kucherov. They're on a mini 2-on-1. They couldn't do anything with it. Kucherov down to Eichel. Eichel along the boards. Kucherov picks it up. Tory Krug takes it. And I think this one's going to be over, fellas. 12 seconds left. I don't know if there's goalie is even pulled or not. He's not. Shesterkin never came out the net. Tory Krug back to Stamkos. This game is over. Vitek Vanacek and the Speedsters have done it. They find a way to upset the number one seed Playmakers. And now we have our finals. Speed versus the Goons. Completely different things. Evgeny Malkin leading the league in points. Game one, let's see what can happen. And Nathan MacKinnon has been great at scoring goals. They find a way to do it again. But Tom Wilson finds a way to score a goal. Willie Nylander gets one back. Steven Stamkos finds the back of the net. But Claude Giroux said, no, 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 we're coming right back. 10 minutes left. Vitek Vanacek. Oh, Matthew Tkachuk. Vitek cannot hold down the fort. And it's buzzing here in Goon Square Garden. A 3-3 game. Dustin Byfuglien, 5 block shots. Jamie Benn skates it up. They're starting their fourth line. They love to do that. This Goon team loves to do it. They're skating down. Dylan Larkin has the puck. Turning around. Finds Morgan Rielly. A shot. Markstrom trying to find his way. He's been very good so far. Both goaltenders have been pretty good. Ryan Reeves. Look at him skating it out of danger to Jamie Benn. Shot. What a save by Vitek Vanacek. But Benn steals it again. Around to Getzlaf. Getzlaf finds Ristolainen to Ryan Reeves. Ryan Reeves. Uh-oh. He just dumps it back down. A great play. Ryan Getzlaf trying to get the puck. Ryan Reeves gets it back and he gets laid out. Getzlaf. Jimmy Benn, oh my goodness, I don't even know what's happening. Zadorov finds Ryan Reeves. There's cycling on this Speedsters team. Nylander picks it up. Here comes the Speedsters first line. Matt Barzal finds Dylan Larkin. 13 seconds left in the period. Here they come. Can he get a shot? A save by Markstrom, and it just goes wide. Jamie Benn takes it, and he gets it poked off his stick. Can they just hold it here? Zadorov to Getzlaf, and we're going overtime. Oh, he's dead! Somebody killed him! His bald head's on the ice! The Speedsters came out and have 45 shots and we're going to overtime. I can't believe they have allowed 45 shots. Evgeny Malkin ties him up. Brad Marchand gets the puck. Tom Wilson looking around, finding Tom Wilson to Brad Marchand, a shot. Connor McSecondary assist to Quinn Hughes. Quinn Hughes skating it up, dangles him. What a move! And what a play by Dustin Byfuglien to get back. He finds Tom Wilson. Tom Wilson looking up. What can he find? What can he market here? He finds Brad Marchand. Marchand a shot. And Evgeny Malkin does it! Again, the Glendale Goons, the overtime winner! The Glendale Goons team refuses to lose in overtime. Can the Glendale Goons sweep here? Can they sweep this team? Nazem Kadri gets one, and the Goons are just... they just know a way to beat Vitek Vanacek. And the goons score again. Claude Giroux. The goons are playing one hell of a game. And Connor McSecondary assist. He's been there whenever this team has needed him. Claude Giroux might have just sealed the game. I don't know if the Speedsters are going to be able to get two. I just don't know. I don't know if it's possible for them. And there's about 4 minutes left in the game, and the Speedsters need two goals. Their Cinderella story could come to an end here if they don't do something soon. Bufflin skates out. Evander Kane gets absolutely killed. Finds Barzell. Barzell skating it up. Turns around. Shifty. Look at him. He's skating up. A move for absolutely no reason at all. Trying to find Nylander, but he'll take that instead. I don't know who that is. He's up to Barzell. Nylander just couldn't get it. Here comes Drew Doughty to Tyler Bertuzzi. Tyler Bertuzzi skating it around. Just trying to kill some clock. They're going to have to get on him here. The Speedsters are going to have to go. They're going to have to get aggressive. Tyler Bertuzzi takes it. A minute left in the game. Tyler Bertuzzi to Dustin Bufflin. A shot blocked by William Nylander. They need to get the puck. Klingberg skating it up. He's looking. He's trying to find anything, and he's dead. Dustin Bufflin doing what the goons do. Oh, but he gets him back. Here he comes skating in front of shot. Markstrom the save. He's been so good. First line against first line. Like we said, this goons first line has just been dominant for some reason. He finds McDavid. McDavid turning around. McDavid looking. They need to get a shot. Cale Makar takes the shot. Here goes over to Tom Wilson. Tom Wilson looking around. Skating it out of trouble himself with only 28 seconds left. He's doing all the dirty work. He gets hit, but he picks up the puck again. Tom Wilson. Oh, he tried to find Marchand. Here comes Gaudreau. Gaudreau tries a move. Wouldn't work. You just need possession. It looks like the Speedsters are going to go home with 12 seconds left. 10 seconds left. Tom Wilson skates it out of danger yet again. 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, 1, and the Glendale Goons, they have done it. All of them spilling over the bench. Ryan Getzlaf, Jordan Binnington, and there goes your Conn Smythe winner, Evgeny Malkin. 5 goals, 4 assists, a +5 for 9 points and 4 hits. You played great. Ew, he's ugly as shit, though. God damn, Gino. Why'd they even give you that haircut? You look awful. What a squad. What a roster they put together. Look at Ryan Getzlaf. Ooh, he's so fucking ugly. The Goons beat the Speedsters. I can't believe it. And so there you have it. If you had all the skills, apparently EA thinks that the goon skill, the trait to just get under people's skin, the trait to hit people, to let them know you're there, that's the trait that EA thinks is most important, obviously. I appreciate you guys for stopping by. I'll see you in the next one. This was a fun video to make, as always. I'll see you guys. Peace.